Welcome back to our Proactive Studios. I'm Natalie Stoberman, joined by the CEO and director of Red Light Holland, Todd Shapiro. Todd, thank you for joining us.
Yeah, of course. Thank you, Natalie, for having me. How are you?
I'm doing so well, and I'm so looking forward to this conversation and finding out how Red Light Holland specializes in a very niche industry of psychedelics.
Yeah, I mean, we're really doing a lot of different things, but a core focus for sure is working with psychedelic magic truffles in the Netherlands. So we can definitely explore any questions you have regarding that.
All right. So psychedelics in Holland, how does that all tie together with being located in Canada as well?
Yeah, so about 3 years ago, we'll be, 3 years listed as of late May. We took a company public called Red Light Holland, which it still is today. And the basis of the original raise and coming to market was working within a legal framework in the Netherlands to sell microdose packs made of magic truffles. And when I say magic truffles, just sort of for, you know, a layman's term, think of the underground portion of the mushroom. A mycologist would say it's a lot more detailed than that, but we don't have the time today to really get into it, other than the fact that you can have different substrates and strains like a tampinensis, Mexicana, Galindoy, and sell them in microdose packs. And that was the original pitch. But, you know, fast forward 3 years later, we've done a hell of a lot more, and we're super proud of the progress that Red Light Holland has made.
And in terms of progress, there has been recent updates about perhaps exploring licensing. Where's the company with that?
Yeah, well, you know, let me backtrack a little bit because to give some context. So in the Netherlands, we are allowed to sell magic truffles on a recreational market. So what we do is we have a farm that produces them. We then package them. We own a company called SR Wholesale that distributes not just our brand of truffles, but a plethora of different brands of truffles to the legal market, to, you know, hundreds of different smart shops across the Netherlands. And smart shops, just think of sort of like head shops, seed shops, you know, places where you get like kind of some cool, funky products, including our magic truffles. And that distribution company is a significant source of our revenues. As well, we own two retail shops now, one smart shop in Os, which is a town in the Netherlands. The other one is called Utrecht, or, you know, I'm not Dutch. So, and that is also in a really cool college town. So you can get magic truffles there. With that being said, that's in its raw, natural, unprocessed form. So one of the things we really got our eye on, and we've had our eye on this for quite some time, is what is the progress within Canada? What are these different emerging markets? How are they looking as to how they will eventually distribute psilocybin? And of course, at the end of the day, we're like to consider ourselves a health and wellness company. And of course, we can't make medical claims, but we all see what's going on with a tragic mental health crisis, really across North America, but really the globe, in frightening times ever since COVID. And it's really tragic. We want to do our very best. Anecdotally, we can talk about how magic truffles can help. We're seeing thousands of great stories, especially in Canada, of how people are using magic mushrooms, whether they're terminally ill or very sadly, or going through like a, you know, a very severe trauma, and what they're doing in order to help themselves. Canada has talked about exemption 56s. They're slowly graduating into the SAP, the Special Access Program. And in the interim, some of the reports you're talking about is, you know, you can never predict where the future will be when and if regulations may permit for a regular use of psychedelics, meaning, you know, Natalie, you might have some of your own trauma, so you might want to have the right to try. So Red Light has really been very careful and cautious with our spending, but we sort of feel that now is the time that is right. Now is the time, you know, now is the right time, I should say, on pursuing, looking at expanding our farm in New Brunswick, which currently produces up to 5,000 pounds of shiitake mushrooms a week. And we're very close to 100% capacity there, in case people are wondering. We sell shiitake mushrooms, which are just an exotic mushroom, to restaurants, to Toronto, to Montreal, to you know, anywhere in Ottawa. So we're really, you know, have a very well-functioning operational shiitake mushroom farm. But we want to look to see if potentially we can get it controlled substances and dealer's license. So we've hired a firm called CLE, and they have a an amazing track record of getting in formerly of cannabis companies, these licenses, Health Canada approved licenses to be able to grow cannabis and produce cannabis, eventually do R&D on cannabis and distribute cannabis. So these are the types of things we're thinking about for our magic truffles in the Netherlands, or perhaps grow our own magic mushrooms right here in Canada. So we're really excited about that announcement and sort of the idea that at some point we can potentially renovate this farm to get it up to standards to be able to do those things.
And when it comes to expansion, though it's exciting, Todd, it's all about timing. And when you consider the relationship that the company has being listed on the OTC, how could that help propel that kind of expansion to have perhaps a successful 2023?
Yeah, we're grateful for the uplist at the OTCQB. And you know, listen, at the end of the day, investors come into a company, you know, you'd like to think they pour into a company, of course, do your due diligence, speak to financial advisors, all this kind of stuff. But it gets eyes on a company, it gets talk going, it gets more exposure, it gets liquidity and volume. So, you know, being on the OTCQB is a very significant step for us. We also like it. Listen, you know, if you're a current shareholder, it's not like there's these crazy listing fees and all this kind of stuff. Like, they're a very reasonable exchange. You know, get the process. Was it like this, like, really insane process that it might be to get to some of these major exchanges? And yet you still get the same kind of exposure. You get the access for people in America to be able to buy it on apps now, where that's not necessarily the case in the past. So the way that Canadians are used to trading it on the CSE, I'd like to think that Americans can sort of have similar access in America. So we're really excited to be on a new exchange.
Great. And we wish you all the best. Thank you so much for stopping by, Todd.
Thank you very much for having me.
Again, the CEO and director of Red Light Holland, Todd Shapiro.